Surfboard. When I started picking the songs that I gravitated towards, because I've recorded about 80 songs, it was the songs that were more effortless for me, that stuck around, that I still love just as much as I loved a year ago when I recorded them.
I've been drinking.
So there was this new producer, Details, and he had this really hard beat, and he had this song called Trunk. And I'm like, that's what I want to sing. I kind of freestyled the verse.
Drunk and low.
And Jay went in and he just started flowing out his verse. We just kind of had a party.
See all the shit that I heard. No, I slid Clint Eastwood. Hope you handle this curve. No, go back Eastwood. No, I handle this curve. No, I slid Clint Eastwood. Halfway there, my G. Another round of that Deuce, we there.
And then Timbaland pulled out his keys, and it was so great because it wasn't about any ego. It wasn't even about, we weren't trying to make a hit record. We were just having fun. And I think you can hear that in the record. This is probably the most organic shoot I've ever done. We decided 2 days ago to do this video, and it was so much fun. It's just on the beach, and it was just us two, and it was perfect.
Fucked up my Warhol, slid the panties right to the side, ain't got the time to take drawers off on sight.
I wanted to carry this idea of being in the moment and embracing mistakes and effortlessness into the videos. I wish every video was like Drunk. It's been interesting the last few videos. We've been like deciding what we're gonna do as we're there. And there's something about that freedom that is different for me, because I usually plan things and I'm trying to rebel against perfection. It's fun because you just never know what's gonna happen.
I mean, I remember we were driving around the 4th Ward and there was a guy riding a horse going down the sidewalk.
Beyonce has done everything and she's done it so well on such a large scale, so I wanted to bring it in and make something small and fun and lo-fi, and everything was handheld and there was no lighting and very run and gun.
More than who I thought you were before, cause you're.
We just got out of the minivan, we started walking down all these alleyways and steps, and we were in people's houses, and chickens on the street, people dancing, people playing. There's just so much to shoot when you're in an environment like that.
We didn't touch anything up. We did it without any theater or exaggeration. There was so much beauty that kind of just innately was in the people and in the city.
But I think it's nice if you and everybody just walks up together.
All right,
like just having fun. And
it was amazing, because at one point we're like in the arcade, and I say to Beyonce, like, let's just do this. You want to open the door and you're going to perform and we're just going to walk out and see what happens. And she was like, yeah, let's go for it. And literally we came out the door and it was like just hundreds of people started coming around us. People everywhere and cameras, people yelling her name. It was incredible. I've never experienced anything like that. It was really reportage, loose, not planned. We went with feeling, we went with instinct, you know. It's a beautiful cycle of energies.
Really just about fun and art and, you know, creativity that is instant. Whatever comes into your head at that moment, you can't plan it. It's just something so refreshing about that. If it was my choice, I would never have a permit. I would just get in the car, get a camera, and we just shoot. And trust me, we tried.
Hello.
Say that one more time. Say, Rao just did a Dougie battle with Beyonce.
Rao did do a Dougie battle with Beyonce.
And killed it. Beyonce is the shit.